Covey Pro Nation, welcome to another Covey Pro. Tonight, in our main event, Louis G. Rich will be defending the Covey Pro Heavyweight Championship. But who will be his opponent? Let's find out right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Jim Cornette!
Thank you. We've got to determine the order of those matches. So at this point in time, I've got a coin. I'm going to flip it. And we're going to see who goes first for the Covey Pro title.
Eric!
Crazy! Mr. Cornette, that's where Berkeley Springs. And this is Hard Rock City. I'm going to choose what I use. And that's heads!
Heads it is. Let's see what happens. It's heads! There you go. Congratulations, young man, and good luck to you.
Come on, let's go!
So you heard it here, Chris Wylde will have first crack at the Covey Pro Heavyweight title.
So it's official. Tonight in our main event, it will be Chris Wylde challenging the Wrestler of the Millennium for the Heavyweight title. But right now, let's go to our opening contest. The Covey Pro Tag Team titles are up for grabs as D-Line challenges Double Dragon.
The D-Line versus Double Dragon for the Covey Pro Tag Team titles. We've been waiting on this, Donnie.
This is not going to be a pretty one.
Oh, no. He's going for the Guerrero special
already.
Oh, he
just hit him with the belt again?
Come on, Justin. Guerrero special already?
Oh, come on, Bill.
Bodysnatcher's got him by the ears. And lights him up in the corner.
Well, it's worth a try.
Dirty tricks only get you so far.
Well, it seemed pissed off Bodysnatcher, which I'm not sure was the greatest thing.
Big scoop.
This is not...
Running power slam from the Bodysnatcher.
I didn't even have to finish the end well part. That was implied.
They've been wanting to get their hands on Justin Tyme for a while now, Donnie.
Well, they're doing it because Bill seems to be infatuated with Buddha. I mean, Buddha's a good-looking guy, but come on, Bill. Watch the match.
There's a tag out to Black Ice and continuing to work on the ribs and back of poor old Justin Tyme.
I know it's breaking your heart, isn't it, Chris?
I cry so many tears for him.
You had to laugh right there to keep from crying, I know.
Big back elbow, even bigger clothesline from Justin. There's a tag out to Buddha.
Well, now they're in trouble.
Raining in them double axe handles and stomping away on Black Ice.
Hey, have you heard Wrestle Talk? Did you hear Buddha call in last week?
He talked so much.
Oh, he did, but he talked about how he was training last week. He was just going around Philly, having to pick out the two biggest, baddest guys in the neighborhood and beat them down. He had a two-whooping limit before he could go home every night.
With Big Buddha, that doesn't take long to reach that limit.
Well, he hit both of them while he was on the phone call.
Nobody home. WMDDT out of Black Ice. Short and sweet and to the point. There's a hook of the leg.
Good save for Justin. And he was just in time that time.
He knows how to work that ring for every inch and work that clock for every second.
Well, the bad thing is, Buddha's definitely in the wrong neighborhood.
Double Irish whip. Spike!
Wow.
Did you see Buddha bounce?
Well, I'm glad he bounced. I didn't think the ring was going to be able to hold it.
Another save from Justin required after that elbow drop. Even Big Buddha, I don't think, was going to kick out after that.
He started it. Oh, he's
going right to the eyes.
Well, I was going to say Justin seemed to upset Body Snatcher, but
there's the tag out to Justin Tyme. And as Dusty Rhodes recall, we got a little bit of clubbering going on in the corner.
Oh, that's exactly what the Dragons need right now. Now they've finally got one of the D-line over in their neighborhood.
Smart technical wrestling. Smart tag team wrestling. Cut the ring in half. Make them fight for every inch to tag out.
How you doing, ladies and gentlemen? I'm the newest up-and-coming star at Covey Pro Wrestling. Your Saturday Night Delight, Brown Sugar Jones. I ain't always been the nicest guy, so I always depend on my friends, whether Holtz Bonding, to have my back. Now they're located in Martinsburg, West Virginia, at 306 West Stephens Street. You can also give them a ring there on the phone, 304-267-5888. They offer affordable financing. Tell them Brown Sugar sent you.
Still got sign guy over there as well, so it's, you know, theoretically a
three on one at this moment.
Well, I wasn't gonna say that. He's minding his business.
There's the rear chin lock from Justin Tyme. Got that knee placed perfectly right in the small of the back. Ring positioning great. Big elbow drop from Justin. Make it two. Third time's a charm. And he's so proud of himself.
Maybe just a bit too much time.
Proud is good, cocky can be bad.
Oh, the impact of the other three, I would have thought he would have stayed down a little longer too.
You do not want to trade blows with the Body Snatcher.
No, that's not something on anyone's list of fun things to do on a Friday or Saturday night.
You can hear these fans chanting for the D-line. There's a tag out to Big Buddha. And he starts in with the Cocoa Butts.
Man, baby!
That silenced the fans real quick.
It did.
Irish whip, reversal. Jumping clothesline from the Body Snatcher.
He tried to strip the ball, but the ball that time was Buddha's head. He tried to take it clean off.
Both men are down. Wild Bill putting in the count.
Well, not good.
Buddha was up, but not quick enough to stop the tag to Black Ice.
Well, now the fresh and fired up Black Ice. Well, until now.
You can't build up your eyes, Donnie.
Big slam by Buddha.
Look at the focus of attack. You can't build the eyes. You can't build the joints. You can't build the windpipe. Love or hate Double Dragon, they know how to focus on the weak points.
Oh, and he just caught Body Snatcher snoozing, and he's got company.
Hey,
wait, who's this moron?
Who's the guy in the lucha hood?
Security! Where's security? Why aren't they? That guy ran out of the crowd. What?
Dragon's breath from a fan?
That's no fan! That's Ian Cross!
Mötley 2 in the house? And he blinded.
Oh, come
double,
on.
Double spear. There's a hook of the leg.
I don't believe what just happened. Mötley 2 was taken out of this. Scotty's not in this match. Ian shows up, runs out of the crowd. Come on, Ian. You talk about Double Dragon and how they got to go over dirty. Your champs are still dirty, Chris.
Karma caught up with and took him apart with a double spear. Karma finally come home to Double Dragon. The end of the year of the dragon is at an end.
Ian Cross already made sure that Buddha and Justin Tyme will not walk away tonight with the tag team belts. But it seems like his problem with Double Dragon is just getting started. And let's not forget, he knows them better than anyone. He and Buddha actually were tag team champions at one point. Let's see one of their matches as we open the Covey Pro vault.
There's no countouts in this match, correct, Larry?
There's no what?
No countouts.
No.
Because they got to go get the ladder?
Yeah.
Oh, Big Buddha just knocked LG.
Oh, look at that. That's cheating. Come on.
All right,
come on, ref. Get in there. Do your job.
That's not cheating, Larry.
Yeah, that's cheating.
Good tag team wrestling, Larry.
That's not it.
Brandon Bishop getting beaten like they ever.
I think you. Oh, my goodness.
Almost.
What was going on?
Great teamwork. Great teamwork.
That's not good. Come on, go talk to me. Pay attention to the match.
Diablo and Buddha. Richie, pay attention to the match, man. A good match going on.
Yeah, Richard, pay attention. Yeah.
There we go. I tell you what, El Diablo and Buddha's taking it to him, Larry.
Well, you know what? See this right here? This card, reversal. You know what that means?
He must have slid off that long hair that Brandon Bishop's got. Nice.
Hey,
nice.
Don't make fun of his attire. Just because you like to go, what is that kid doing?
Right. Military style.
Yeah, I know. Military see my military style? Yeah. See it right here?
Yeah, you like a
that's
Charlie Sheen. Like a Charlie Sheen throwback.
You know what? That's the Quaker Oats guy right there.
Hey, Eddie Van Halen.
Hey, don't make fun of Eddie Van Halen. He's very talented. Look at this match.
Splenda.
They're still cheating. Splenda. You know why they're cheating? They're cheating.
They want to be with tag
because they're doing something. Yeah. No, they're not good.
Yeah, he told you, Larry, because they're good.
Hey, Silver and each. Hey, don't encourage him.
Come here, buddy.
Don't encourage him.
Tell Larry in the mic what you said, because they're what?
They're good.
Well, he's young, right, so I can understand. Sooner or later, he's going to grow up smarter.
Smile for mom.
That's a good picture right there. You can send that in. If you really want a good picture, son, come over here.
Mom's going to look at that all night, son.
Hey.
Watch this. Uh-oh. El Diablo.
Look at that.
What is this, Larry?
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh.
Wow.
That's a lot of man to get moving through the air.
Wow.
Let's hear it for Buddha.
Goodness gracious. Wow. You said that once.
Wow, Larry.
You said it again.
I hate.
What do you
I
hate?
Don't know what I hate, Larry.
I think Lewis Rich is hurt. We need to take a timeout here.
Lewis, there's no timeout in wrestling, Larry.
This is a ladder match. You said rules are different. Great excitement outside the ring here. What's that? Ah. He's beating the chair. Not yet, Charlie Brown.
Uh-oh, Buddha's going for one.
Uh-oh.
Buddha's going for a ladder.
We got
Charlie Brown's all happy. Buddha's going for a ladder. Here we go. Look at
what do you think, Marcus Freeze? You want the ladder in the ring or what? Yeah. Are you guys awake out there? I know you are. You had your sugar cream donut. You're all amped up.
El Diablo, he's just flying over these ropes.
Ooh. We definitely got action inside and outside the ring.
Uh-oh.
This is education. Oh, my goodness. Talk about luck.
Lewis Rich. Oh, Bishop dunked that one.
Oh, yeah, that's some good wrestling technique right
Charlie
there.
Charlie Brown is giving us every blow by blow.
No, can't be that. Not yet. Not yet. Patience. It's like Heinz 57.
Anticipation.
That's right.
Anticipation.
Oh, my goodness.
Lewis G. Rich here. As a former Covey Pro tag team champion, there's nothing I won't do to get my tag title back, which sometimes means things that are outside of the law. But I never worry because I know I can always call Eric S. Black, attorney at law. That's Eric S. Black, attorney at law. 304-258-2931. So remember, when you see the blue, call the black.
Hello, Covey Pro Nation. This is Big John Green. Hey, have you ever thought about becoming a professional wrestler, a referee, a ring announcer? If you want to get in on the action, come on down. Give us a call at 304-298-2192 or 240-421-1938. Join us at our Covey Pro Dojo for training for you to become a professional. We're located right behind the Earth Dog Cafe on 522 in beautiful downtown Berkeley Springs.
Oh, my goodness. Berkeley Springs is getting behind the great Duncan here. We can't have that.
His name is Buddha.
Buddha's coming up to the top. Oh, that's why these guys are so good. What is it again? They are the Bay City Thrashers. Say it, folks.
Yeah.
Love it. The Bay City Thrashers.
The only good thing about them, though, is the Baltimore Ravens are from that city.
That's
Baltimore Ravens.
See that young man right there? He's a good guy.
Hey, you just turn around and watch him.
You just blew it, boy.
Steelers, who are the Steelers?
They lost the Super Bowl.
They lost the Super Bowl. They're like,
let's watch this wrestling match
let's
here.
Let's watch wrestling.
Tell ya. I don't know, Buckley Springs, what do you think? He's going up to the top for the belt.
Lewis,
folks.
Buddha's going to take it.
No, Buddha's going over.
Oh, my goodness. Lewis is trying to climb. Uh-oh, Buddha's got him.
Watch out, Larry. No, this is terrible. This is cheating. Oh, my goodness. What a great competitive match we got going on here. This is craziness.
This is one of the best teams I've seen against Bay City, Buddha and El Diablo. Their teamwork, their chemistry.
Are you awake over there?
I'm awake.
Okay.
I'm watching Buddha just lay them hammers into the back.
Are you sure you're awake?
Nice body slam from Big Buddha.
What is he going to do now?
Oh,
right in the back. That's cheating.
To the back.
Come on, ref, get in there, wake that up.
That's not cheating.
Yes, it is.
Hardcore wrestling.
No, it is not.
No, he's got the ladder in position.
I don't know if he's climbing. Get him over there. Look, here's the team line. Going off the second rope.
Oh,
right in the rear caboose there.
Wow.
You couldn't miss that signal.
Wow.
And that, oh my goodness.
Charlie Brown called it a rib shot.
That's
Diablo's got Brandon Bishop outside the ring here.
My goodness.
Now Diablo's going up. The tag titles are close.
Oh my goodness.
The tag titles are close.
Ah, Lewis G. Rich. That's right, folks. Remember the name.
Tag titles are close, Larry.
Yeah.
Oh!
Awesome. Wow, Brooklyn Springs, what do you think about that? That's some craziness, isn't it? That was an angle slam.
It was an angle slam.
What you got there? You got a whole bunch of cool toys right there in the ring. I bet you can play imaginary G.I. Joe with that.
Larry, why don't you go down there and help this guy out in the ring here wrestling with his little figures. He needs help. I'll call the match. Lewis Rich using the ladder to his advantage, Larry. Now tell me that's not cheating.
Larry, what are you doing?
What's up?
I'm watching something. This ain't good. It ain't.
Charles.
Yes, it is good. We can talk about Charlie Brown. He's got a block.
There's no way he's going to get booed up.
Booed with the reverse.
Oh, my goodness.
Booed with the reverse. Oh, that's going to leave a mark. Ref, he's cheating.
Oh, no.
That's good stuff right there. That's good, Buckley Springs. What do you think? That's pretty funny, isn't it? That looks like a lefty mark.
Go on, Buckley Springs. Let's get behind El Diablo with Buddha.
Can't do it. Lewis, just did. He delivered the goods. What do you think about that?
I think it's
that's
stinks,
right, Larry.
I think
it's
stinks, Larry.
That was awesome. Brooklyn Springs, was that not cool? What? Yeah. Let me hear it. What? Ref, get in there. We're cheating again.
Don't get Richie confused, Larry.
Right? Oh my goodness. We got all kinds of
cross body block off the top rope.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Big Buddha with the suplex, side suplex.
Oh, stunner.
Stunner from Brandon Bishop.
Oh, my goodness.
I think it's going to take more than that, though, to beat Buddha.
I think you're right, but. Oh, my goodness. Well, come on, Lewis.
Bishop getting ready.
Yes, he is.
Bishop.
The Bay City Thrashers, folks. Let's get behind them. Come on. Let's make some noise for Bay City Thrashers.
Woo!
That's it.
Come on. He's got those up. He's climbing with him.
Uh-oh. This is where it gets hairy, scary. Right there in another midsection shot.
Well, Diablo's hanging on, though.
Yeah, but he's going down quick.
Hanging on.
Reminds me of some people I know. I didn't mean that in a bad way. Oh, my goodness.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
Well, Diablo's up there.
We can't have that.
He's close.
Oh, my goodness.
He's close.
Something. He can't get it. Maybe his partner on he can't pull it. This is a trick match. Uh-oh, now we got both ladders. Goodness gracious.
Lewis Rich has got a ladder.
Yes, he does.
Oh!
He knocks.
Cross body block on the ladder down. On the Brandon Bishop.
Yes. See, Lewis G. Rich is smart. Now he's using both ladders.
That's your opinion, Larry.
It is.
That's your opinion.
It is.
Not a very good one, but that's your opinion.
It is a good one, and it is my opinion.
We got Buda and Lewis G. climbing.
That's it. It's a race.
Buda's the stronger of the two, I do believe.
And we got a standoff.
Headbutt. Big Buda.
And a chin up. A midsection blow. Another one. Oh, monster headbutt.
Headbutt.
Oh, my goodness.
Lewis off the ladder. Buda.
Oh, no. This ain't happening. No, this can't happen. Oh, my goodness, no.
They're in his grass.
No.
Come on, Larry.
No.
Come on, Larry.
No. Oh, my goodness.
We have new tag team.
Here are your winners and the new Covey Pro Tag Team Champions of the Open Cup and Big Buddha.
What a match.
It's time for a quick commercial break, but still to come, Chris Wylde will be challenging Lewis G. Rich for the Covey Pro Heavyweight title. We'll be right back.
Hi, everybody. This is Jim Cornette. If you need an attorney, you want one with integrity, compassion, and excellence. The Iceman, Nicholas Colvin, attorney at law. He could have talked Nixon out of Watergate, and he can help you.
304-260-8823. If you or your loved ones need more than just an average lawyer, you need to choose a champion. Call now, 304-260-8823.
Call the Iceman.
Fantastic. Go ahead and let's make that up. Fox's Pizza, 304-258-8000. They do deliver, 304-258-8000. Oh my goodness, let's open that up. Stay here and open that up with me. Oh, that's definitely a pizza for Big John Green. Fox's Pizza is a proud sponsor of Covey Pro Wrestling and a major ticket outlet.
Double Dragon, January, Mötley 2 came rolling into town, and we rock and rolled all over everybody's faces, including yours. Until you pulled out the mist and every dirty trick you could find. Well, guess what? Just because Feel Good goes down with an ankle injury, that don't mean Mötley 2's done. Act like you ain't never seen a band. Touring band. Rotating members, boys. Mötley 2 is coming for you. Tit for tat. Ask Boot about that.
Hello again, you're watching Covey Pro Wrestling. Earlier tonight we saw Jim Cornette deciding who would face LGR for the heavyweight title tonight with a coin toss. Chris Wylde won the coin toss, so Crazii Shea will have to wait until next week to face whoever leaves with the belt tonight. Nation, Lewis G. Rich versus Chris Wylde for the heavyweight title starts right now.
Lewis G. Rich.
Sure.
Championship bout coming up. The first title defense for LGR tonight. One of possibly two.
The odds are against LGR leaving tonight as heavyweight champion. 33.3% chance of retaining.
Yeah, well, you said that in your notes, of course, but LGR's got that figured out.
If anyone can pull it off, LGR, credit given where due, a heck of a champion, a heck of a wrestler. But he's made a lot of enemies. There's the lockup.
Well, you're right. There's definitely no love lost between these two.
Chris feels he was screwed out of the title. He wants what he feels he never lost. He never even got a proper shake at it in his mind. And he wants Louis G in the worst way.
Well, you saw that desire play out to get him to this point even.
Back in the collar elbow. Louis G forces Chris back in the corner. We're going to get a clean break.
Then again, you really got to think about it. The biggest show of the year, All or Nothing 9, would you really want the champion, the wrestler of the millennium, the king of Maryland, Louis G. Rich, on this stage?
Of course you want Louis G. Rich on this stage. This is our biggest show of the year. This is our main event. This is it. And this is our big time player. Louis G. Rich, credit given where due. King of Memphis, King of Maryland. Heck, he could be the King of Memphis if he wanted to.
Yeah, probably so. Jerry might not like it.
We got a stalemate going on between Chris and Louis right now. Big rear waist lock from Chris Wilde.
Well, we've seen him before. They definitely know each other well.
Louis power through, right into the forearm dragon twist. Extends it and got that arm barred beautifully. Front slip escape, right into the forearm dragon twist of his own from Chris Wilde.
Well, Chris Wilde returning the favor, and Louis G. There we go.
Back heel drip right into a side headlock. Making Chris carry his weight. Great positioning. He's got to watch for his shoulders.
Well, you see, LGR seems to have things well within his grasp right now. He's keeping Chris Wilde grounded.
Great move to counter that head scissor escape. Louis G is a smart wrestler. He's a thinking man's champion. The shoot off from Chris Wilde and a big shoulder block from Louis G. Rich.
Yeah. I think they answered Lewis was the man. That's what I heard. Caught him sleeping.
Lewis doesn't know how to react to this.
I don't know what he's doing either.
Chris is all balled up. Lewis has no idea how to handle this.
Who would? What do you really do? Hey, just kick him a couple times, I guess.
Oh. Arm drag out of a small boy.
Wow.
Went for the iron. No luck. There's the roll up. And there's the arm drag that Lewis was looking for. And a drop kick to boot.
Well, Chris Wylde on fire and LGR wisely taking a trip outside.
I think as many mind games as Lewis G. Rich has played, I think Chris Wylde is playing mind games as Lewis G. Incoming!
Not a good place to be. And second verse.
Oh!
Slightly different, but just as painful as the first.
Corkscrew plancha from Chris Wylde, and Lewis G. ate all of that.
Oh, he has seen better days, that's for sure.
Slingshot senton from Chris Wylde.
Oh, the aerial attack just continues.
Hook of the leg, only two. Chris is staying focused on Lewis, and that's his best bet in the situation. Wear him down.
Well, we've seen both of them wrestle to their strengths. Chris has finally got that aerial attack going, and LGR was showing his technical prowess.
Funny thing here, Donnie, the longer this match goes, you know who it's better for? Crazii Shea.
That's true, because regardless of who comes out, the longer this goes, the more damage done. Shea's basically picking the carcass of whoever's left over.
Speaking of damage done, twice Chris Wylde eats that ring post with his shoulder. It does not give.
Well, and it's still not given. As this time, LGR introduces him to it.
Just stretching him around it and the ring post.
We have talked about it, we've said it before, and that's why I brought up, why would you want Lewis G. Rich at the biggest show of the year, All or Nothing 9? As vicious, as sadistic as Lewis has been.
Because love him or hate him, you're going to get a hell of a match out of him every time.
You're going to get the best and the worst out of Lewis G. Rich at this venue.
And look at the man's focus. He found a weak point on Chris Wylde and is bound and determined to destroy it. He's going after that left arm viciously.
He is locked on now.
Chris doesn't have a heck of a lot of weak points, but the second he hit that corner post, he earned one, and Lewis is not letting up.
Newspaper, water hose, crowbar, you are not prying Lewis off that arm.
Chris off the ropes. Went for left arm clothesline, no luck.
He doesn't have anything left. That arm, that shows you how damaged that arm is.
Shoulder stunner. Only two, and if you notice, Lewis G didn't hook the leg that time. He extended the arm. He was going after the elbow at the same time.
Well, put pain on him, make you think twice about kicking out in that situation.
Beautiful positioning from Lewis G Rich. The arm is barred. His right forearm is digging into the shoulder joint. Beautiful position from our champion.
He is, and he's got it locked in close. He's able to maintain that control.
And a great leg lariat from the champion.
Some desperation shots from Chris Wylde, but
only two.
You run into that lariat. And Lewis is in firm control at this point.
Staying focused. There's the forearm drag and twist again.
You can just see the pain in Chris Wilde's face.
Look at his position. Great escape by Chris Wylde.
And he still did damage. He's still favoring that arm.
Hi, I'm Covey Pro Superstar and the voice of reason, Dashing Donnie Diablo. When I tell you you should make the trip down to 979 North Frederick Avenue in Gaithersburg to King Volkswagen Kia, you know I'm telling you the truth. At King VW, you'll be treated right, from our state-of-the-art service department to our knowledgeable sales staff. King Volkswagen's commitment to service makes car buying fun again. And you won't have to wrestle us for the best prices and service all around.
There was the Greco-Roman eye rake you're so fond of.
Right back to the arm.
That shoulder has been taking so much damage.
Lewis knows he's got this. Lewis.
Lewis.
He smells it. He feels it. He knows.
Wild firing back with those chops. His left arm may be dead, but that right isn't.
Oh, there you go. Wild trying to, you know, make a liar out of me. Lewis had to jump in there and show him what's what.
The shark with blood, Lewis G. Rich. There's the hook of the leg. Hook of the inside leg, making Chris have to use that shoulder.
You know, I mean, everybody talks about the heart of Chris Wilde. We've heard it numerous times, but you've said it, heard it everywhere else about how much heart Chris Wilde has. But
the heart of a warrior.
Well, you know, that's all fine and dandy. Have as much heart as you want, but at this point, you're really playing with your career.
That spin back outside kick, and the headbutt didn't do Lewis G. Rich any favors, and Wild's going north.
I mean, that arm's basically dead and hanging at this point. He's still trying to get filling back in it.
Went for the senton on the way home. Sky high bomb.
Oh, I thought Lewis had him.
Beautifully done by Lewis G. Rich.
Hey, you can see Lewis thought he had him too. I can't believe he kicked out of that. But then again, it goes back to the whole heart thing. We've established he certainly has more heart than he has brains, or he would have stayed down on that.
Looks like Lewis G's going for a variation of Fujiwara armbar.
Well, Lewis is just going to tear that arm up. You know, Chris, you're too dumb to stay down.
Chris has turned into it a little bit, taking some of that pressure off, but Lewis G has got that locked in tight.
Well, that's where your heart's gonna come into failure. You know, you kicked out, you stayed in this, and now that Lewis has his opportunity to do more damage.
Chris is looking for an opportunity. Now he's trying to make an opportunity with those splashes. Nobody home. There's a patented shoulder block, and almost he went for the Northern Lariat, but Chris is ignoring it.
Well, Chris
takes Lewis's head off with a clothesline. Elbow shot.
Oh, wow.
Springboard crossbody from Chris Wild.
Well, Chris seems to be firing back up. Oh, maybe that heart is
face wash from Chris Wild.
Well, Lewis definitely seen better days.
Big cannonball in the corner.
Lewis is just draped across that bottom rope, and he is in trouble.
Chris is trying to get him set.
Oh, this is...
Oh, he's got him set.
Not good.
Swing out neck breaker from the ropes.
Wow. Chris pulling out all the stops.
Only two on our champion.
As innovative as it was...
As big of a heart as Chris Wilde has, props given to the champion, Lewis G. Rich. We know how hard he'll fight.
LGR will do anything, and he said he will do anything to retain that title.
Big clap to the ears. There goes your equilibrium, Chris.
You know, we add on to that. We had the champ out here last month, him talking about neither one of these guys deserve another shot. He's beat them. He beat both of them.
Sky high stun.
That's
strong. That's usually the kill shot. Two. Only two by millimeters.
Well, we talked about the heart of Chris Wilde. Now we got to talk about the heart of LGR.
That sky high cutter from Chris Wilde is usually a kill shot.
I mean, you saw what he had to go through to get the title. You think he's going to let it go that easy? I mean, not that that was easy. That was an incredible shot.
Run in STO from the champ. And both these men are almost out of gas.
Well, that was a desperation move.
Only two.
LGR, Chris Wylde, possibly. They may both be running on just pure will and instinct at this point.
What has Louis G. Rich got to do to take out Chris Wylde? But what
stake
is Chris,
to the heart? I don't
what
know.
Has Chris got to do to stop Louis G.?
He probably set the place on fire. Oh, wait. Come on. Charles taking the belt away?
Louis G. had no point having that belt in here.
That's it. We'll watch it here, Charles. Just bring it over here. All right, we got it. It's good.
Super kick from Wylde.
It ain't going anywhere, Charles. We got it. You're good.
You're good. We got
big clothesline from LGR. He just took Chris Wylde's head off.
What happened? I missed it.
Big clothesline from LGR.
Ladies and gentlemen.
There was nothing shiny in his hand, Chris.
The winner.
Nothing. Nothing. Stop. Just look this way. Look at me. Don't look at any of that in there. It was a big clothesline. He took out Chris Wylde. Chris Wylde didn't belong in the match. Louis G. Rich proved it. It was a great match, but Louis came out on top. Great clothesline. We've talked about it. Louis G. Rich, a great technical wrestler. Just pay no attention to whatever.
You're telling me no power of the punch, quote unquote?
No, absolutely not. You didn't see it, did you?
I saw him stick his hand into his tights. You never know what Louis is going to pull out of him.
It was just scratching. He had an itch. There's a slight rash. We were out in the woods earlier, maybe some poison ivy. That's not to be worried about. What is important is he's still our champion.
By hook or by crook, Louis G. Rich still the heavyweight champion. His odds jump from 33.3 to 50%. All he's got to do is get by Shea. That's easier said than done.
You said it. It is easier said than done, and not just because Shea's coming for that title, but this is very, very personal.
Chris Wylde proved to have the heart of a warrior as he fought like never before. However, the outcome was the same as last time, and LGR was able to retain the Covey Pro Heavyweight title. Now the question is, can Crazii Shea slow down the wrestler of the millennium, or will he just be another victim? The answer next week, so be sure to tune in, Covey Pro Nation. Well, this is it for me tonight. I hope you enjoyed the show. Remember to get online to check out all the videos at CoveyPro.com. Have a good night, everyone.